Hello dear learners, today we will see coefficient of correlation and regression analysis in detail. Now what is coefficient of correlation? So in case of bivariate population and in case of multivariate population, there are different type of correlation. Means in case of bivariate population, the correlation can be studied through three process, that is cross-tabulation, Charles-Pearson's coefficient of correlation and Karl-Pearson's coefficient of correlation. Now what is Karl-Pearson's coefficient of correlation? So it is the technique whereas cause and effect relationship can be studied through simple regression equations. And here in case of multivariate population, the correlation can be studied through two methods. The first is coefficient of multiple correlation and coefficient of partial correlation. Now what is partial correlation? So here the cause and effect relationship can be studied through multiple regression equations. So here we can apply the simple regression equations, but here we should go for multiple regression equations. Now the next is cross-tabulation approach. So what is cross-tabulation approach and when we can use it? So when we can go for cross-tabulation approach, it is useful when the data are in a nominal form. Under it, we classify each variable into two or more categories and then cross-classify the variable in the subcategories. First, we have to classify the variable into categories and then we should go for subcategories. Then we look for interaction between them, which may be symmetrical, reciprocal, and we can say asymmetrical. Now what are the type of interaction should be there between them? So what is symmetrical relationship? So it is the relationship in which two variables vary together, but we assume that neither variable is due to the other. Means both the variables are vary together, but they are not dependent on each other. This is a symmetrical relationship. A reciprocal relationship exists when? So it is exist when the two variables mutually influence each other. And what is asymmetrical relationship? So it is said to exist if one variable, which one? We can say independent variable, is responsible for another variable. Means one is dependent on other. So other one is independent. And that independent variable will be the cause for another variable. That is asymmetrical relationship. Now we will see the next. The cross classification procedure begins with a two-way table, which indicates whether there is no or there is. The cross classification procedure begins with a two-way table, which indicates that whether there is or there is not and relationship, or we can say interrelationship, between the variables. Means what? This sort of analysis can be further elaborated in which a third factor is introduced. Here we can apply the third factor into the association through cross-classifying the three variables. Means what should we can do? That your one factor will be constant and other two we can measure. Means by doing so, we find conditional relationship in which factor X appears to affect factor Y only when factor Z is held constant. We can measure the effect of one factor on another and the third factor will be constant. Now the next is Charles Spearman's coefficient of correlation. The other name of this coefficient of correlation is the rank analysis. Now what is the rank analysis? So obviously here we have to give the rank. So to determine the degree of correlation between two variables in case of ordinal data, where ranks are given to the different values of the variable, here we have to give the rank. So this coefficient is determined by this equation, Rs means Spearman's coefficient of correlation. By this equation, we can identify it. Here we have to give the rank. That's why the other name is rank analysis. Now the next, the Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation. The other name of this correlation is simple correlation. Some assumptions are there for this type of correlation is there is a linear relationship between the two variables. There should be a linear relationship between two variables. Then second is the two variables are causally related, which means that one of the variable is independent, but other one is dependent. And the third one, a large number of independent causes are operating in both variables so as to produce a normal distribution. This is about a simple correlation. We can say Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation. Now this is the equation, how we can go for it, means how we can identify it. Alternatively, the formula can be written by this, or we can write it by this. This is the formulas to find out Carl Pearson's coefficient. Now the next is simple regression analysis. So what is regression first? So regression is a determination of statistical relationship between two or more variables. In simple regression, what happened? We have only two variables. One variable, we can say independent, is the cause of the behavior of another one. That should be dependent. So regression can only interpret what exists physically. For example, we can measure the physical effect. There must be a physical way in which independent variable, we can say X, can affect dependent variable Y. So the basic relationship between X and Y is given by this equation. Now, generally, it is used method to find the best fit that a straight line of this kind can give is the least square method. To use it efficiently, we first determine A and B by using this equations. After that, this measures define A and B, which will give the best possible fit through the original X and Y points, and the value of R can then be worked out as under. Means by this equation we can find the simple regression analysis. Now we will see the type of correlation. So there are generally four type of correlation. First is the perfect positive correlation, where R should be plus 1. This is a positive correlation. Then partial positive correlation, perfect negative correlation. What is partial positive? It should be like this, in between the value of these two. Then what is perfect negative correlation, where R should be negative, perfectly negative, means this one. And what is partial negative? R should be in between these values. And one is no correlation. So these are the type of correlation as well as regression analysis. Now in the next lecture, we will study about the chi-square test. Thank you, dear learners, for watching the video.